Hello everyone, and welcome to Cumberland, Maryland. I'm outside the Western Maryland station built in 1913. This magnificent station doesn't actually serve Amtrak. Amtrak is served by a modern station further up the hill. But this line is still served by the Western Maryland Scenic Railroad, which we're gonna ride on today. Let's go. Shoot, I wasn't on the platform when the train's coming in. Stairs two at a time. Here we go. Here we are on board. I'm riding in the open air car, which is a converted passenger car from some era. I'm going to find out when it was from. And my mom's here. Say hi, Mom.
Hi. So are you gonna narrate this?
Probably gonna do voiceover for most of it. So I'm walking around the train before we leave. And this car definitely feels like it used to belong to the MBTA commuter rail. You got the pink paint, and you got the MBTA commuter rail smell, which is a thing. Does anyone else, like, notice a particular smell for the MBTA commuter rail? Let me know in the comments below. But this car has also been modified to have a snack bar, which is pretty awesome. Here we go. The Western Maryland Scenic Railroad runs 16 miles from Cumberland to Frostburg, climbing over 1,000 feet into the Appalachian Mountains through a deep water gap known as the Cumberland Narrows. The line was operated as a branch of the Western Maryland Railroad until 1973, then sat abandoned until the 1980s, when a joint effort between Allegheny County and the City of Cumberland created the Tourist Line. Today, the line parallels the Allegheny Highlands Trail, and the two cross each other frequently. Brush Tunnel is the only tunnel on the route. The shadows of our open-air car, cast by the tunnel's lighting, reminded my mom of Plato's allegory of the cave. Let me know in the comments if you can tell me the connection. All the time. He made the freight train boogie as he rolled down the line.
Enjoying yourself?
Yes, I am.
After a little over an hour of travel, we pulled into the Frostburg Depot, which was built in 1891 by the Cumberland and Pennsylvania Railroad.
So I'm still not sure where this car came from, but here's a clue. The signage is in French. I'm thinking something Canadian. So we have made it to the town of Frostburg. My ears have popped because of the elevation change. And let's take a look at the train. Back here we can see some track speeders. If you want to know what it's like to ride one of those, you can check out my track inspection train video, which I made a few weeks ago. Down here at the end of the train, we can see some former Southern Pacific cars, which are now first class and dining cars, I believe. Next up we have the Ocean View Dome car. This is an interesting one, because up until 2019, this actually belonged to Amtrak. Amtrak ran this car on the Adirondack and Downeaster on a seasonal basis, and I actually got to ride it with my roommate David in 2018. So it's fun to be reunited and it feels so good. Next we have our possible ex-MBTA car. My friends on the Miles in Transit Discord server have said it is a Messerschmitt. I'm not sure if it looks like one or not because I can't really tell the cars apart. You guys will have to tell me in the comments. Here's the basic coach class car, and here we have our open air car. Still not sure where either of them came from. And then finally we have our locomotive, number 501.
This locomotive is a 1963 built GP30, which originally saw service on the Pennsylvania Railroad. Decoupled from the train, the engine is turned on the Frostburg turntable, which was originally built by the Western Maryland to serve the city of Elkins, West Virginia. In addition to 501, the railroad owns an ex-Amtrak F40PH, a 280 steam locomotive currently undergoing restoration, and, well, we'll get to that. After the turntable show, I met with David, our train's brakeman, who gave me permission to film inside the rest of the train, including the Ocean View Dome car.
So I'm back in here for the first time since 2018. Let's see how it's changed. I definitely remember the ceiling being this short, but it's a lot cleaner. You can really see out of the windows, whereas before, they were a bit fogged up. Now I believe this was the window that was smashed by a tree branch shortly after I rode this car. Interesting to see they haven't really replaced it. Now we're going into the lower level of the dome car. The bar is actually open this time. Last time I was here on Amtrak, it was closed. Overall, it definitely looks like they took good care of it. So, if you get a chance to ride it, go and pass it up. And now for the Southern Pacific cars. I've loved looking at pictures of the Southern Pacific daylight over the years. So it's fun to actually be inside one of these trains. Albeit in the Appalachian Mountains. Okay, this is classy.
Zero exercise value.
Oh.
Yo, I just discovered this car has a barber chair. I wonder how easy it is to cut hair on a moving train. There is literally a shower stall on this train car. And remember kids, loose talk can cost lives. So now we're leaving the station and heading up into Frostburg. Mom, what are we looking for?
Ice cream.
And here we are.
This is the mocha.
Update, the line at the cafe was super long and they were scrambling to fill orders, so we are heading back down the hill to get some ice cream near the train station. Okay, ice cream take two. Right across from the station, there is the Frostburg Carriage Museum. As you can see, there are carriages. This one here is particularly special. It was Theodore Roosevelt's inaugural carriage, and it was actually bulletproofed. All right, museum has been visited. Ice cream has been got. Time to get back on the train. Okay, new clue as to the mystery of our open air car's origin. AMT, Agence Métropolitaine de Transport. AMT was the former branding of Montreal's commuter rail services. So this quite possibly was a commuter rail car from the Montreal era. It's done its time on tourist railroads, and now it's here.
My mom and I sat on the opposite side of the train going downhill, which led to some excellent vistas. Classy rail travel tip, sit on the right side of the train going uphill, and on the left side going down. You won't regret it. You gotta leave me now. You gotta go alone. As we descended, I reflected on how this is the end of an era for the Western Maryland Scenic Railroad. The railroad has been restoring compound articulated locomotive number 1309, one of the biggest steam engines ever built. And last year, the locomotive ran on its own power for the first time in over half a century. Now the railroad is replacing its aging ties, preparing for this weighty locomotive to take over hauling regular tourist trains. Today, the Western Maryland Scenic Railroad is a typical tourist line with good service and pleasant views. But next year, it's going to be one of the biggest destinations for steam enthusiasts on the East Coast. I, for one, can't wait.
Take every chance you dare. I'll still be there when you come back down. When you come back down.
As we pulled into Cumberland, we paralleled CSX's route on the opposite bank, which carries the daily Amtrak Capital Limited between Washington, D.C. and Chicago.
Awaiting your return, my greatest fear will be that you will crash and burn, and I won't feel your fear.
Hello. It was fun. We had a good time.
And here we are, back in Cumberland. Did you enjoy yourself?
Yes. I sure did. Thank you, especially the ice cream.
If you're ever in Cumberland, definitely check out the Western Maryland Scenic Railroad. Worth a day trip. Take care. And I'll be on the other end to hear you when you call. Angel, you were born to fly, and if you get too high.